Today I'm going to speak to you about the fatty liver. So what is fatty liver? Fatty liver, we say it's the accumulation of mainly triglycerides in the liver. When it accumulates or occupies around 5% or more of the liver tissue, at that time we say that this is fatty liver. It's common in the obese patient. It's common in the people whom they consume alcohol. Statistically, when we say, or roughly speaking, we say that if people drink like 6 grams of alcohol per day for about 10 years, 100% they will get or develop fatty liver. Also, the obese patient, around 80% of those obese patients will develop fatty liver. The risk factor for the fatty liver, as I told you, it's the obesity, alcohol consuming, some other drugs if people are taking, in the hyperthyroid patients, and in some diseases also, like if there is hepatitis C viral infection, and sometimes you'll find it genetically runs in family. When those patients come to us and we diagnose them with only fatty liver, we have to exclude some other diseases so that we'll only say that this, yes, this is a fatty liver. Because most of other liver diseases, they come with the same clinical picture, as if the, in the case of viral hepatitis, whether hepatitis B, hepatitis C, the chronic viral hepatitis, whether autoimmune diseases, whether what we call it hemochromatosis, in which there is iron and ferritin overload in the liver, and some other disease like thyroid also, sometimes it affects the liver. How or what's the workup for those patients? We have to do them blood tests, we have to do liver functions, we have to do them or exclude, as I said before, the other chronic liver disease, which we can see them. It's simple blood test. And of course, with the diagnosis with the FibroScan, this will make the condition very easy. How to direct those patients for not developing this fatty liver? Especially, we'll speak about the younger age group, the adolescents, because now this is, it's like the number one disease in those adolescents group. We have to advise them for the diet, we have to advise them for the exercise, and of course, the avoid fatty liver. Also, it's very common in the age group of the 40 and 50 as age advances. Also, they have to take care of their diet and food. We have to plan them also for regular visit and regular follow-up so that those fatty liver patients, they don't develop or progress the disease into more advanced cases, which we call them alcoholic or cirrhotic hepatitis or fibrotic hepatitis. Because when this happens, there is liver cell failure, and at that time the patient will develop more complication than it's only fatty liver.